1604-4224. It may have peaked at around 900 and something volts. It took it about a minute and a half, 2 minutes to get up there. Yeah, it took about as long to ramp up as it does to shut down. Anyway, here's this, and this, this. They can make this freaking program save this, but not this. You gotta sit here and go through each one that you want. Won't save it. So, that rumbling. Here's the smooth portions, obviously, that rumble. Right there. It rum, or maybe a rum. There's that rumble. That's what it does. But this thing acts so much like a Newman machine. If it isn't built right, I mean, it acts so much like one. Other than the rumbling, it takes so much time to get going. It'll run on for so long after you disconnect the power. It's got pretty good torque. It's running at high voltage, like his was at 900. I think that's where he ran his, 900, 1,000 volts. Which I think is at the pretty high end of those coils. I really shouldn't be pushing it much beyond that. Rumble, 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 rumble. That's what it does when it rumbles. Looks to me like it's shoving the voltage in. It increases. Get taller, that's when it's rumbling.
Yeah, here's a picture of this thing starting up. That's around 7-8 pounds flywheel there. This is running at around 700 volts. That's about as fast as it runs. It'll go a little faster, I think.
Right now it's at 600. It'll slowly rise to 7. That'll drop to 1.75 milliamps. Now this is using a closer brush on there rather than skimming them. 9 volts, half amp.
That'll slowly drop. That will slowly rise. We're using the second scale. Now this should be accurate. Should be. That's connected right to the output of the high voltage going into the coils. This is running from the output and from this into that. It runs from here and back out again,
right?
But that'll make it up to about 700. But I lowered the brush, it's now contacting. That's the brushes you hear. That's that brush. But we are down, we're at 500 volts, pulling 1.9, almost 2 milliamps. That thing's still pegged. So there's the difference, but it runs faster. Shut that down. So that there, apparently it's peaked at 450 volts, about 2 milliamps, 1.9596. Input is down to 8 volts at a half amp. This all stays cool. I've got it running at 700 volts, 1.75 milliamps. I've got about 9 volts in and a half amp. Brushes, they're hitting most of the time, but the wheel is wobbly. Here's the scope on it. From what I've had before, I mean this now, it's all positive. These numbers, this is on a 0.5 scale, these numbers, I've got the probe scope going through this resistor, which is a times 50, times 75, 100, I don't know, going to the output of this, which goes to the coils. So this is reading around 700 volts going through that resistor, whatever it is. And at least I got a scope reading on it. It's running at 24 kilohertz really. 26. I know that's right. That's the duty cycle. But it runs positive. That's at the 1.2 megahertz range. This is using the globe high voltage power supply. It's rezzing. You can see it in here.
balloon that up. Can't even balloon it up. Why don't I just do this and then do that? So that's what it looks like at 26 kilohertz. It's running around
40 RPM.
You see the background in here. This starts around 50 megahertz, no, 5 megahertz. Those glitches, that's the other brush, occasionally arcing. Like that.